Before Obaseki, there was Edo State. And after Obaseki, Edo State will continue. Politicians, they come and they go, but the state remains. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Please do not forget to hit the red button before you exit this video. Thank you very much and I appreciate you guys. Let's go into this video right away. Leadership is defined by results, not by attributes and not by making speeches or being liked. A true leader produces more leaders and not more followers. There's a saying that two captains cannot sail in a boat. That means one has to step aside. Unfortunately, our politicians today all want to be leaders. They all want to be in a leadership position. No, I mean none of them wants to take the back seat. Abraham Lincoln of blessed memory said, "If you want to test a man's character, give him power. As we all know, power corrupts. And absolute power corrupts absolutely." Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me ask this question. Is it worth it? I ask again, is it worth it? Are the politicians in Edo State worth all this fighting, all this endangerment of our youths, all this, call it whatever you want to call it, people? These politicians, are they worth it? Are they worth it? Are they worth the big divide, division that they have caused amongst our youth? They used to be united. So many youths have been incarcerated already, leading to like 5 or 6 weeks into the elections. Some of these youths are going to die before elections. And some will die after elections. Why? For who? For the sake of some self-centered politicians who care less about you, whose only motive, whose only intent is to gain power and control, whose only intent is to gain dominance, no matter what it costs, at any cost. According to our dear brother and uncle, Nnamdi Kanu of the Biafrans, he said, liberation at any cost. I mean, if it leads to him alone standing as the only living being in Igbo land, as long as Biafra gets liberation. That is the mindset of the politicians that we have. Edo State in this case. So many divisions, so many issues, siblings fighting against each other, husband and wife fighting against each other. Is it worth it, my people? Very painful. Very painful to see our youth in the streets of Edo State, Benin City in particular, chanting, beating drums of war because of one person. Because of a political figure. At the end of the day, what is the price? What do they get? 1 million naira? In some cases, 500,000? And even sometimes, 5,000 or 10,000 naira. Are you going to use that to mortgage your future? The same politician that care less about you, that does not even know if you exist, the same politician you are hailing is the same politician you are killing yourselves for. A politician that is living in safety, have everything to his comfort. And you, the citizens, the youths that are bearing the cost of everything. The same you youths are, oh goodness. Why, my people, why? Oh, why? Why? Why cry for now? Why? What have these politicians done for you? Who they don't help? Who they help? Oh, so painful. Youths wanna be like this. Wanna they sell away on our futures. Wanna they sell away on our future because of talking. Eh? Oh. So painful. Eh? Good leadership teaches its citizens how to fish, not give them fish. What these leaders are doing to you, they give you money to go and buy, to go and cruise, to go and do whatever, but they are not actually put you in a good place that will stabilize you, that will give you a sustainable future. Can't you get it? Oh, wanna be like this now, wanna be like this. And dear Nigerian people, wanna be say, when you eat today, you forget about tomorrow. Eh? Why? Unfortunately, so many in Edo State, my Edo people. Yes, part of me is from Edo State, so me, I must talk. I don't go quiet. We all own that Edo State together. I have asked some people, I said, what is the hula balo about? And I got to understand that they see it as Auchi and Bini battle. Oh, wait, oh, damn it. Auchi and Bini battle. Not a fight to liberate the state. It's about Auchima and Binima. That is why you are fighting. Oh, yeah. Anyways, I'm not coming here to criticize you. I come in peace, like I said. Ladies and gentlemen, for your information, former APC chairman Adam Sosomole is not fighting to become a governor again. He's only supporting Eze Iyamo. And we all have the right to support whoever we want to. Abi? So, how does that make this war, this battle, this field between Auchi and Bini? Eze Iyamo is from Bini. Obaseki is from Bini. Both men are a product of Edo State. They are both from Bini City. So why are we making this Oshomole versus Obaseki's matter? Why? My people, when they look me now, why not be him? Why is it about the individuals, but not the interests of the states? Why? Why? Have we sat down and take a deep breath and even think, how did all this started? How did it started? We are not going to go into the genesis of it all. But we are going to say the way things are now. The status quo, the political state, is very, very toxic. Take a deep breath. Sit back and look at Edo State about 8 years ago. Compare it to now. Edo State 6 years ago. Compare it to what it is. Even 4 years ago. Let's talk about the youths. All the youths that are fighting against each other right now, they're the same youths that were brought out with, eating together, having a collective collective interest. The youths that you see today are youths that were banded with the same ideology, the same love, the same brotherhood many years ago, few years ago here, as APC members. Now, na come tear yourself apart, fighting against each other bitterly. Why? How are the mighty falling? What went wrong? Because Obaseki is an Ebene man, Oshomole is an Auchi man. Is that all it is? What about the interests of your party? What about the interests of your state? Let me tell you guys, one tree cannot make a forest. Before Obaseki, there was Edo State. And after Obaseki, Edo State will continue. Politicians, they come and they go, but the state remains. About 8-6 years ago, so many who were supporters of Oshomole, where are they today? The government of Oshomole favored them. When Oshomole left, the music changed. Then comes Obaseki. And don't forget, Obaseki will soon leave too. Even though he wins this election, he's also going to leave. Politicians, they are on transit. There's no permanent political position. He's going to leave. And what's going to happen to his supporters? then what will happen to you, the supporter, that is feeling grandiose, untouchable? What's going to happen to you when the next government comes and it's that government that doesn't favor you? Have you thought about that? But the youths, they will remain. Why? Is it worth it? Is it worth it? These politicians have nothing to offer you. During the week, I asked some of my governor's supporters, what has this man really done? They talk about Ogbe Stadium. I said, Ogbe Stadium is not a new, the Samuel Gbemidia Stadium. Samuel Gbemidia Stadium is not a new project. It has been there. There have always been ongoing renovations. And the reason why the governor decided to take it up was because of the National Sport Festival, Abi, Kinimotinkwe. Now suppose that's coming. That is the reason for the renovation. The last time that it was renovated, I guess, was in 2002, Abi, thereabout. This is not the first time renovation have taken place. And to the best of my knowledge, they said around 2018, October, that project supposed, that renovation supposed to have been completed. 2018, October. They never finish them. It's not finished. Although I know they blame it on COVID. There are a lot of projects like that that are so unfinished. It's so typical that when governors, when politicians come into power, they want to impress the first 100 days. And after that, waiting they happen, the next projects now will be activated when election they come. Why are we being fooled all the time? Why would they be fooled? I'm not against Obaseki. I'm not for Somali. I'm not for Obaseki. But for me, I want a government that tomorrow I can just land in Muritala Mohammed Airport, take God is good transportation, Edo State, Benin City, here I come, and I will be free to go anywhere. How many of us can boast of that? That we go just reach Edo State today and we are free to go to Ring Road anytime, to go around the whole place. Eh? How many of us dare free? What I'm trying to, I've asked a lot of people, what has this man done? Me, I'm not CEO, I'm sorry, not to offend anybody. All I'm hearing about is policies. Which policies now? I know they said he stopped Agberoism. Me, I never heard that word before, Agberoism. It's during Obaseki term I heard about Agberoism. And what about that? Every state get touts. Every state get Agberos. Every state get different kind of people. And we all work together as one. There is no state, there is no community that is free of whatever they call Agbero. By the ways, with the same Agbero not there before Obaseki came into power? Why were they not forced? Why were they not much fuss about it then? Is it not the same so-called Agbero? Isn't that kind of did what they know how to do best, or however they did it, that brought Obaseki into power? Did you guys think Obaseki won that election against Izeyamu in 2016? I pray. Do you think he won? In fact, Edo State never wanted him. His own people never wanted him. Oshomole has to force Governor Obaseki down everybody's throat for us to accept him. So why are we crying more than the bereaved now? Where all these supporters, everybody, where they did that time? Where Oshomole was literally begging everybody to accept him. Where they did that time? So now, because they now fall apart now. So you now know, say you now get brother. This is my brother. This one now, Auchi. Is it about tribe? Because that is what I see here. Let me remind you, before you start making distinctions about their languages, where they come from and all that, this is not about tribe. This is about the interests of those states. Somebody say he picked somebody. Make it bring her up politically. And the thing no come work. He no want again. He no want support him again. That is the only crime that this Baba Osho Baba has committed. I don't know Osho Baba personally. I don't know Obaseki personally. But I know them as illustrious sons of Edo State. So, I can't take side with any of them. But I'm just going by what I'm saying. Why everybody like this? So much toxicity in the air about Obaseki. What kind of spell is that? That spell no warm you. I don't tell somebody, say me, I tell my waiting. Do they say, you stop at Berozi, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's say, Agberozi isn't existed. Okay, it's like saying, you are good at farming, take farming job. You are good at this, do this. I mean, Oshomole was able to bring everybody under one roof, carry everybody along. Eh? He was able to do that. He was able to suppress whatever you call them. So now, are you not saying there's no Agberoism? Edo State is this time in Edo State is the most insecure time ever since history. Not even in the time of Lucky Benito, in the time of Oyegu, in the time of Adamusume. This time is the most secure time in Edo State. And people still they come out, still they beat drums of this thing. I mean, why would they do like this? Why is it just about what we are going to eat today, not about tomorrow? Each time I travel in the street of Lagos, I see a lot of Benin people. I see a lot of Edo people, I mean to say. Who dare not even board a deck where God is good or Yare or Fosa or whatever to Edo State? I say, ah, why now? You say, hey, the place is not there safe. And these are the same people when they still carry drums, still they chant or pass. Why now, my people? Why do they do like this? Why do they do like this? Now that they make me they cry. Huh? Why? Oh. Why? The one will come pay me as the most painful part of it. If you are not in Obaseki's camp, let me say you did trouble. You go see threat. You go see the touts it's using. Why? It's only one or two persons. So far, very educated and enlightened minds that have agreed that well, you have the right to your opinion. A sister in our community here sent me a post that there's going to be a meeting, like a virtual meeting with Obaseki. I'm invited. I told her I'm not pro Obaseki because I don't see why I should be supporting him. Do you know what she said to me? She said, well, that is your opinion and I respect it. Man, sister, I twale for you. But the others, when they're Nigeria, the ones who even then, this one abroad, this one even there now, I respect her. The ones who are in Nigeria, you dare not say you not support Obaseki. You are in trouble. Is it by fire, by force? Even this governor himself, the way he's attacking people who do not support him, who are not supporting him, is so scary. I wonder what's going to happen if he doesn't win this election. And winning is not by hook or by crook, not by force. In a game, in a game, there must be a loser and a winner. But he is not willing to accept by fire, by force. My dear governor of Edo State, life does not go like that. And I don't blame you because you are very new in the political space. You are so new. From a chairman of a strategic planning at Kinikon, all the way to governor. You didn't go through the process. Eh? This kind of political ambition that you have, that is not how it works. You have to take it step by step. I sure say they just jump, you go up there. So that is why you don't know what it is. That is why you don't value your political mentors. I didn't come here to support or to oppose anybody, but I'm just going by what I'm seeing. There is no need for all this. There's no need for all this division. I've been so quiet. As if I come out come talk now, I don't know the kind of attack I will receive because nobody on social media did say anything that opposes Obaseki's administration or that opposes ambition. Nobody did come out. What did? Hey? Who these politicians, who they help? My dear Governor Obaseki, please, before I ramp up, let me give you a personal advice, one-on-one. You see, a lot of challenges come with being a leader. It's not just moi-moi. It's not just coming there ranting, impeaching people. Even look at Captain Hossa as well. A well-respected Edo man. you fell apart with him as well because he don't support you. He came outside, said, leave him out of this governorship race. Leave him, may you put him down. No, put him for up, leave him, put him down. That is all he said. What is the point of using his cousin against him to go and write? Anyway, anyway, I don't want to talk about that. Anyway, I don't want to go into that. Make I just stay on my lane, Jeje. Just before I go, Governor Obaseki, let me please beg you. Okay? Now beg me, I dey beg you now. So that I will not go see so many deaths. And I feel sorry already for people when we say their life will go down because of this election that is coming up. Let me tell you. The challenges of leadership is to be strong, oh. Strong, but not rude. I see rudeness. Not rude. Be bold, but not be foolish. I see foolishness, oh. Be proud, but not arrogant. Let me talk, not arrogant. Be proud, but don't be arrogant. Be humble. But don't be ruthless. You have been dealing with people ruthlessly. Even the chairman, the suspended chairman himself. No matter what happened, you were once couple. Remember the children that you bought together. I mean, the people of Edo States. The APC party. Although you are no longer APC, happy. You now belong to PDP. Okay. But remember how he helped. Nobody knew you then. Nobody wanted you. Remember those old times for old time's sake. All these people that are chanting and encouraging you, they have their own self-interest. Not because they like you too much, but because of their own self-interest. That is why they are supporting you. But trust me and pray that you don't go down. They will disappear. Be humble. Be humble. Put ruthlessness aside. Don't be ruthless. Okay? Don't act like you are a noble. Like, you are entitled to 8 years. Who said so? Which constitution talk like that? Like you are unstoppable. Nobody can stop your ambition. Seriously? Suffer. Now small, small. Now so me I talk and wish. Obaseki supporters, don't come after me. This is my own opinion. And this is my own candid advice to the governor. Thanks for watching, guys. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye-bye.